Hello. It's gonna be live for 1 hour or so. Unless you want to take my photo.
You need some light?
I think so. Hey, sugar! Can you hear my voice? Hey! I was thinking if I do both, it's gonna be... Hey! Hello! Sawadee ka! Is anyone know some Thai? So... Let's go live. Waiting for live music. Cool. Hey! I just want to make sure if anyone can hear my voice clearly, can you just maybe send love, thumbs up, or anything just to make sure that you can hear my sexy voice? I know now this one, it doesn't work, so I need to go back to my one. Cool. Just wait a second, hey guy. Yeah. Okay, I think I will close this one. All right. So this is my first time that to do the yoga on Facebook Live. Actually, that when we do on Zoom, I see everyone and we have like the interaction. So I know that you are there. We talk, but this time I'm just talk all by myself. Anyway, just let you know. I'm not that crazy. Cool. If we ready, I'm gonna play some music. Ooh, somebody sent me a friend request. Wait a second. Not now. All right. Let's start that. I just want everyone just to make sure that when we do yoga together, so I didn't know your fitness level really for the yoga, how flexible you are, how strong you are. The first thing is don't let your ego overcome your ability. I keep practicing yoga since I was 23. Today I'm 38. So my fitness level, my flexibility, my strength in terms of yoga might be better compared to some of you. Again, for some of you who keep practicing yoga longer than me, you're able to do a fancy pose. Somehow today we don't do the fancy pose, okay? We're gonna do the thing that I want you to listen to your body. Cool. So number one, don't let your ego to overcome your position. If you can, that's fine. It's gonna take some time. All right. Number two, if you have strap, like what Sugar said, you use the strap or block. If you don't have, my recommendation, so go to grab the water bottle, all right? Use any of that, all right? I don't want to promote for any water brand, so I remove the plastic. And if you don't have a strap, guy, using a towel, okay? Smell really good. Cool. So what we're gonna start now, let's start from sitting. So when you sit, make sure to sit in leg cross position, all right? If you have the block, sit on the block. So in this way, we want the hip to be up higher than your knees. It's much easier to let your body stay in upright position, number one. And number two, is allow you to breathe in deeper and slower. If you didn't have, it doesn't matter. or you can using the cushion. So when you're ready, we're gonna do together. So first, keep your left hand, alright? So your left hand is gonna be at your belly and your right hand is gonna be at your chest. And think about your trunk area is the balloon. So when we inhale, think about you put the air to your balloon, so your belly is getting bigger. And you exhale, like you let go the air out of your balloon, so your belly getting smaller. Make it clearer. Inhale, the belly getting bigger. And exhale, your belly getting smaller. All right. So we're gonna do this deep abdominal breathing for 5 deep breaths. Inhale, your belly expands. And once you exhale, your belly is getting smaller, so squeezing your belly in and up. So inhale and exhale. And for some people, if you can sit like this, sit on the chair, find your option, okay? Listen to your body and listen to my voice too. So inhale deeply and exhale. Blow that out to your nose. 2 more deep breaths. Inhale. And exhale. For some people who know that, many times when the yogi doing yoga, we always come up with this word OM, O-M. So for the next 5 deep breaths, when we exhaling, I use the word we, even though I can't hear your voice, we're gonna say OM together with the normal pitch as long as you can. All right, for 5 breaths, so take a deep breath. Inhale, the belly expand. And exhale, OM. Your shoulders back and down and keep your eyes closed softly and gently, letting go all the tension of the COVID-19. Even though this time is social distancing, but I'm sure that our energies connect to each other. Relax muscles all around your body as well as relax your mind. You are here, you are now. Know exactly what you are doing. Right now, you are inhaling. And right now, you are exhaling. And just observe your breathing. The beauty of doing yoga is being in this present moment. So I want all of you guys just be here, not only physically and also mentally. And we promise each other we're gonna get through this 1 hour together. And slowly open your eyes. Ding! All right, so I hope that I'm saying loud enough, okay? The next thing is we're gonna start from the standing position. I'm gonna turn on some music again. If I'm talking too soft or too loud or the music is too loud, you just let you know, put some comment, just letting me know that how it go. All right, if you're ready, so let's start from standing position. Wow. Hey. Cool.
All right. Music. Come on, music.
Ain't no sunshine when she's
gone. So let's start from just keep your hands at your hip and circle your hip first. If you have some fun from the Zumba this morning with your beautiful friend, I'm sure that this posture is going to be easy for you, right? You're going to circle from right to the left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now reverse the circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Keep your legs open just a little wider. Bring your arms up. Inhale. And exhale. Bring your arms down. Keep your knees soft. Inhale, arms up. And exhale. Let's start to rest your heart rate up just a little. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. So give me two more deep breaths. Inhale, exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. So from here, turn your left toe to the left side. Bring your arms up and slowly lower your arm down at your shoulder level. And now sway your body from the center to the left side of the room. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, and hold on. Left hand down, right hand up. Big circle on your right shoulder. 2, 3, 4. And reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4. And hold on. And slowly from here, look up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And slowly bring your body back to the center. We're gonna do the same on the other side. Left foot slightly turn to the right side. Right toe completely turn to the right. Arms at your shoulder level and sway your body all the way to the right side of the room. 3, 4, 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So right hand down, left hand up, make a big circle on the left shoulder. 2, 3, 4, 5, and reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now look up. Stay here for 5 deep breaths. 4, 3, 2. And slowly look down and bring your body all the way back to the center. At this time, do your best to keep your legs straight. Turn your toe point straight. Bring your arms up and close to your ears. Once you exhale, you're gonna leaning forward. Look at the space between your hands. Keep your stomach in. Engage your core. Inhale back to where we start. Exhale. Continue. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. Last one. Inhale. And hold on. Bring your arms open. This is inhale all the way. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 10 times, hey? 5, if you feel so much at your back, keep your knees soft, so keep your knees slightly bent, and concentrate with your arms, move, give me 3 more, 3, 2, and 1, and slowly lower your body all the way down, have the block, using the block. Okay, if you didn't have, using the bottom. Stop. It's gonna be easy for you to see me. So from here, hand on the bottle and keep your right hand up, look up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look down first before we twist the other side. Left hand up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. For some people who are flexible, you can just keep your hand all the way down, and this is an option. You do both sides. Make sure keep your leg straight, alright? And slowly from here, support at your hip and lift your body up. Turn your right and your left foot to the left side. Do your best to keep your leg straight. Inhale and exhale. It's gonna be the right angle pose. So from here, you can check from the screen, right? Do your best to keep your both arms be parallel to each other. If awesome, it is too low for me, remember that you have an option. Either you're using the block or you're using the bottom. Because our main is, we want both legs to be straight. You're opening the hip at the same time, you keep your both arms be parallel to each other. In this position, the triangle pose is really work really hardly at the core and at our both legs. Inhale to your nose. Exhale. Sigh out. Let go all the tension with your out breath. Inhale. And exhale.
In my anguish.
One more deep breath. Inhale. And exhale. And slowly from here, come up to the center. We do the same on the other side. Turn the right toe totally to the right side. Turn the left toe around 45 degrees to the right side. Keep your both legs straight, arms at your shoulder level. Inhale and exhale. So if you already are flexible and practicing yoga for a while, just hold on without any prop. Or else just using the prop, because our aim is we want our both legs to be straight and we want the arms to be parallel to each other. Either you're looking straight, look at me, or look up to the ceiling and hold on for 3 deep breaths. Inhale through your nose and exhale. Sigh out to your mouth. Inhale slowly. Exhale. One more deep breath here. Inhale. And look down. And bring yourself up slowly and back to center. And Michael Jackson, your foot back to the center here. Now, if you have a block, keep the block between your knees. Alright? If not, using the cushion or just using nothing. Knees bend. Slightly, just to make sure that if you look down, you still see your toes. So come up, standing tall, and exhale. Keep your knees bent, just to make sure that your knees not go over your toe. So with a proper squat, 2, 3, 4, 5. Give me 5 more before we go for the chair pose. 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold on. Make sure that you keep your back straight. So keep your stomach in, tuck your tailbone in, sit back to your invisible chair, and raise your arms, looking at the space between your hands. Hold on. 5, 4, 3, 2, hold on, and 5. Come up, slowly take deep breath. Down, hold on again. What? 5. 4. 3. 2. And you know what? You're gonna give me one more round. All the way up. And down. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. And bring yourself up slowly. So, from here, go down. Stay in the kneeling position. Take a deep breath. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, exhale. One more deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Right leg straight, left knee bend. Bring your body all the way up, direct to the gate pose. Feel the stretching at the left side of your body and hold up. When you hold a position, make sure that never ever hold your breath. Hey, inhale slowly to your nose. Exhale. It's gonna be the same like dynamic yoga move. So I want you to feel that your body is getting heat, getting warm. Hands right behind your head. When you exhale, lower your right elbow down to your right leg. Keep squeezing on your right waistline. Feel the stretching on the left side of your body. And go. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. And bring your left arm straight up. 2. 3, 4, keep continue, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and hold up. Keep your both arms straight all the way, stretch your arm to the right side of the room. Feel the deeper stretching at the left side of your body. If possible, let's join your hands together. Face up, look up, hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale back to the center. Good job. And from here, we're gonna do the same on the other side. So first, keep your left knee bent. Keep your left leg straight and keep your right knee bent. Hand right by your head. Do slowly lower your left elbow down and back to the center. 1, 10 times. 2, mainly feel the stretching at the right side of your body. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, just bear with me, pushing yourself, hey, never ever give up, and another 10 times, right arm, straight up, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, almost there, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Bring your both arms straight to the left side of the room. Feel the deeper stretching at the right side of your body, so join your hands together to feel the stretch even more. Fans up, look up. Hold on. 5, 4, 3, and one. And back to to the center. I'm sure that your body is already warm right now. I'm gonna turn the camera to the other way so we can see that what I'm gonna do next, all right? Getting hot. Yes. All right. So, let's start from all four. You keep your knees apart. Make sure that your arms be aligned with your shoulder. Your back should be in neutral position. Once you inhale, you're gonna drop your belly down. Lift your chin, your chest up, look up. And when you exhale, round and round your back, chin to chest, face down, look down. Inhale slowly. And exhale. Inhale and exhale. So give me two more deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. If you don't mind, I'm gonna take off my top. Okay. So when you inhale, drop your belly down, open your chest, face up, look up. When you exhale, round round your back, draw the navel back toward your spine. And hold on here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And from here, keep circle your hip. So, if you have any back pain, I promise you that this position is really helping to relieve all the back pain, especially at your lower back. It might look a little bit sexier, but you know what? Be sexy and pain-free. Why not, right? And reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. So keep your left leg straight. Make sure that you keep your stomach in and bring your right arm forward. It's gonna be that the bird dog position. Lift your left leg up. Make sure that do your best to keep your core strong and tight. And hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's work on the core. Exhale, squeezing your right elbow towards your right left knee. Inhale, exhale, and go. 3, 4, 5 more, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. If possible, that grab your left knee close to your chest. Round your back, hold on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And release slowly. Of course, we are lucky to have only two legs. So the other side, keep your right leg straight, keep your stomach in. Left arm forward and lift your right leg up, hold on here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now exhale, squeezing your right knee towards to your left elbow. So, 2, continue, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, two more, 9, and 10. So hold on, keep your right knee close to your chest, round your back slightly, hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. So we call this one the chai pose. For me, I prefer you to keep your toes together and keep your knees apart and relax your back. Take a deep breath here. Inhale slowly. Exhale. Alright, so don't forget drink the water as well, okay? Be hydrated. Sweating. Cool. So from here, keep your knees apart, lower your hip down, and lift your hip up. Down and up. Get ready to do the next move. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Last one. And hold on. So keep your left hand, hold your left heel or support at your lower back. And keep your right arm up. Then from here, you switch. You know what? I'm gonna lower the music down. And you know what? Yeah! I'm gonna turn the camera to the other way around. Yeah. Oop, you can't turn phone by your life. Oops, sorry. That's my fault. So, I want to. Start from the kneeling position here, alright? I'm gonna show you from the other side, alright? Either if you have any back pain, support your lower back with your both hands, or you want to go to the main camel pose. So keep your toe tucked. Your right hand grab on the top of your right heel and lift your left arm up. Either you support at the back of your head with your left hand, or you try to keep your left arm close your left ear. So this is the option. You can do this one like a 5 second on one side. Same the other side, left hand on the left heel. Right arm up, close to the right ear or support at the back of your head. And hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then relax. So when you relax, either you sit in this position or you're lying all the way down to the child pose just to protect your back. Inhale and exhale slowly. And one more try here. Both hands support at the back, especially at your lower back, all right? Or you tuck your toes and you keep your hands on the heels. So we're gonna do the full camel pose here. I hope that you can see me. Inhale and exhale. Push your hip and your chest up. Face up or just relax your face, relax your neck. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale and exhale, support your lower back and sit back down slowly. So when you're ready, we're gonna go to the next position. It's gonna be a little bit harder. So from here, meow. All right, keep your legs, stay with the all four, and slowly from here, step your right foot next to your right hand, lift your left knee up. Okay, then slowly you're gonna rest your right hand up. Inhale and exhale. Once you exhale, tap your right elbow down toward to the floor. Inhale and exhale. We're gonna do together for 10 times. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So if you want to open your hip a little deeper, do your best to keep your forearms down to the floor with your left knee off the floor or using the block or the book. So keep your forearm on the block or on the book and hold on for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then slowly from here, we're gonna switch. So your left foot gonna be next to your left hand. Alright. Cool. And from here, you're gonna raise your left hand up, look up. And whenever you exhale, keep your left elbow bent and tap the left elbow to the floor. Inhale and exhale. So we're gonna do 4, 10 times and go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One more time and 10. Again, make sure that if you can do it, do so. Keep your forearms down to the floor with your right leg straight back or using a block. And hold on. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And slowly from here, we're gonna do just a little bit of hip opening because I want you to get more flexible and flexible during this quarantine time, right? So keep your palms down, left foot, close your left hand, step your left back, then right foot, close your right hand, and you keep switching. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep continuing. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And from here, step your left foot forward. Option. I want to sit awesome. I'm so freaking tired. So either you're sitting on the block or you're sitting on the small chair, on the small ottoman, all right? Or if you super flexible, just be like me here. Sit with your knees open out wide and let the elbows pushing your knees apart. Draw your hand front of your chest. Namaste. And we're gonna go for the next one that we call that the froggy squat. You're gonna lift the hip up as high as your elbows still touching your knees, all right? Inhale and exhale up for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then back resting in the deep squat position. Draw your hand in a prayer posture. Keep your body staying upright. Your thumb close to your chest and smile. Inhale to your nose. And exhale. Sigh out to your mouth. Let's be with me here for the next 4 deep breaths. Inhale. And exhale. 2 more deep breaths. Inhale. And exhale. One more deep breath here. Inhale. And exhale. And let's do something much easier. Especially I want to concentrate on the breathing exercise today. There is some research, right? Believe that if our lungs are strong enough, hopefully we're able to fight against the COVID-19. And that the reason why you need to work really hard to strengthening your lungs through the breathing exercise. So, with your breathing exercise, mainly we use only with our lungs. Sometimes it's gonna be with the arms movement. However, just bear with me, we are almost there. And I'm so proud for all of you who joined the class, and hopefully that your people gonna just go back and check this live video once again. Cool, sit back in this leg cross position. Like we're talking from the beginning, if you have the block, sitting on the block to keep your hip up higher than your knees. All right, if not, never mind, sitting on the floor or sitting on the chair. Mainly relax your shoulders, relax your arms. So inhale and exhale, roll your shoulder back and down. So for the next 15 to 20 minutes, we really concentrate on the mind-body connection, especially through the breathing. I want all of you to be mindful and be here with me, all right? Even though I didn't see your guy, but I hope you are concentrated on your movement, all right? So, relax the shoulder, keep your arms down, the finger touching to the floor. Inhale, you raise your arms up over the head and exhale. Lower your arms down. Inhale, arms up, and exhale, arms down. Give me three more deep breaths. Inhale, and exhale. Last two deep breaths here. Inhale and exhale. And last one here, inhale, bring your arms up. And once you exhale, so keep your left hand down to the floor and stretch your right arm up close to your right ear. Face up, look up. Feel the deep stretching at the right side of your body. What happens is sometimes that your right knee want to lift itself up, right? Try to pushing your right knee down. And feel the deeper and deeper stretching at the right side of your body. We want to increasing the breathing space by stretching at the side of our body. So this is the point that the more you're stretching, I believe that the better your breathing is gonna be, okay? Stay for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then back to the center. Come to the other side. Keep your right hand down and stretch your left arm up over the head. Feel the deeper stretching at the left side of your body by pressing your left knee down. Face up, look up. Hold on this position with 5 deep breaths. Inhale slowly. Exhale. Whether you're exhaling to your nose or to your mouth, either way, but always keep breathing into your nose, all right? Give me 2 more deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale. 1 more deep breath here. Inhale. And now exhale. So back to the center. So, while at the beginning we are talking about using the strap or using the towel, another way to helping you to increasing the breathing space, and what the consequences is, the better your breathing is, would mean that the stronger, the better function of your lungs to working against the COVID-19. What? So, if you have the strap, fold the strap in half. If not, you're using the towel, all right? So what I want here, keep the towel straight and tight. So you're gonna roll your shoulder back and forward. So when you do, make sure that I want you to keep your arm straight and do your best to keep your back straight as well. Inhale, roll your shoulder back and exhale. All right, inhale and exhale. So make sure that keep your back straight. I don't want you to pop your chest up in this way. Try not to compensate like this, hey? So try to keep your back as straight as you can by keep your stomach in at all time. So give me 5 more. Inhale, exhale, 5. Inhale, exhale, 4. Inhale and exhale, 3. Last 2. Inhale and exhale, 2. Last 1. Inhale. Now I'm gonna show you from the back. If you're holding whether the strap or you're holding the towel, lower your right hand down, okay? Keep your both arms straight and try to pull the towel or the strap. So you should feel the stretching at the left shoulder. And slowly from here, you're gonna make a big circle from right to the left side. Inhale and exhale, slowly 2, 3, and remember, do your best to keep your arms straight. 4, one more round here, and 5. And now, left turn. So keep the strap or the towel tight, lower the strap down with your left hand. So you should feel the stretching on the right shoulder, on the right chest. And start to make a big circle from left to the right side. 5, 4, your arms straight, keep the strap tight. 3, 2, and 1. And slowly from here, see that the way that I'm holding the strap, you're gonna keep the strap or the towel behind your back and turn your palm facing up, squeezing at your shoulder blades. You're gonna try to lift your arms up and keep squeezing at your shoulder blades at all time, and continue to squeeze at your shoulder blades for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, whoo, 10, 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Leaning forward, lift your arms up and away from your back. And try to keep your back, your neck stay long, stay tall. Keep squeezing at your shoulder blades. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And release. So, once the tension around the shoulder is gone, now we're gonna try to let go the tension around your neck, around my neck too. So sit back and relax your shoulder, relax your arms. So try to nod your head side to side, to the left, to the right. So you should feel the stretching at the opposite side of your neck. Inhale, lower the right ear, close your right shoulder. Back to the center, exhale. Inhale, lower your left ear, close to your left shoulder. And keep continue like this for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, think about that. When the kid just want to tell you that, I didn't do anything, mom. I didn't do anything. And hold on. Roll your right shoulder back to feel the deeper stretching at the right side of your neck. Keep your left hand cover your right ear and gently pushing your left ear closer to your left shoulder. You want to feel the deeper stretching at the right side of your neck? Keep your right arm straight down, using only the tip of your finger pressing down. And keep your face up, look up. So we're living in the world that full of confusion right now. it might lead us to become an overthinker. But by keep thinking so much, a lot of tension that we also created. And without knowingly, the tension is go to your shoulders, go to your neck. The best way is not to think. But if you can control that, maybe the easier way, just keep stretching to let go some of the tension that no longer deserve you. And release slowly. So we're gonna do the same on the other side, all right? So keep your right ear closer to your right shoulder and keep your right hand pressing the head down to feel the deeper stretching at the left side of your neck. And the same way you want to feel deeper stretching, keep your left arm straight down and turn your face up or just keep your eyes closed. Again, the longer I keep stretching, which means the more I let go, and the more I let go, the more I relax, and the better I feel. Let go all the tension that not deserve to be within you. And release slowly. So, when your neck, your shoulders, no tension, hopefully, we allow us to sit in this leg cross, to sit in this meditation pose for a long period of time, and make sure that you always observe your body. If you see me right now, or if you have the mirrors in front of you, check your position. Do I put a lot of tension on my face? If it's, just relax, all right? Relax your jaw muscles, relax your cheek, relax your eye socket, relax muscles around your eyes. Your neck, your throat, your shoulders, totally relax. Turn your palm facing up, because in terms of the yogi science, we believe that we want to receive the energy from the universe, from those surrounding. So if at this time we don't have anything to give, just prefer to receive. All right, nothing wrong to receive the energy from those surrounding, right? And relax your shoulders back and down. Like what we do from the beginning, inhale, the belly expand. And exhale, you draw the navel in and upward. So try to lock at the root chakra, which is just mean that try to squeezing at from your pelvic floor muscles. Whether you're a woman or you're a guy, we all have the pelvic floor muscles, the muscles down there that helping us to strengthen, helping us to hold the pee or not to pass the air in the public, so that muscles. So inhale, the belly expand. And exhale, squeezing your stomach in, squeezing your pelvic floor muscles inward and upward. Especially any woman who do the yoga with me right now, remember this is the key word. We really want to strengthen our pelvic floor muscles in at any age. Okay, so inhale, the belly expand. And exhale, so squeeze your stomach in, squeezing your pelvic floor muscles in and up. So inhale deeply, the belly expands, chest expands. And when you exhale, scoop your stomach in and squeezing at your pelvic floor muscles in and upward. So give me one more deep breath. Inhale, the belly expands and exhale. So inhale to your nose. And when you exhale, you're gonna say this word with me, Om, like what we did from the beginning, we're gonna do as well for 5 rounds. So inhale, the belly expand. And exhale, Om. Oh. Alright, and for the next breathing, we're gonna just divide the word OM into three parts, A, U, and MA. Alright, for the word A, think about from the belly all the way down to your buttock, to your hip, to your thigh, to your knees, to your calf muscles, to your ankle joints, to your feet, all the way to your tiptoes. So think about this word A. This is the energy that we want to create to ourselves, especially to the lower part. So for the next three deep breath, when you exhaling, you're gonna say the word ah, and visualize that the energy flow all the way from the belly down to the tip of your toes. All right, so it's gonna be like this. Relax your shoulders, inhale. And now we're gonna say U. The word U just represents the energy that gives to the middle part of your body, from your neck down to your shoulders, to your upper arms, elbows, forearm, wrist joint, your hands all the way to the tip of your finger, from your chest to your belly, from your upper back, middle back to your lower back. So for the next three deep breath, we're gonna say the word U. When we exhaling, do it as long as you can. All right, so you want to feel more, keep one hand at your belly, keep the other hand at your chest, so you can feel the vibration around your trunk area. So inhale. U. Alright, and come to the last word, MA. Now the word MA is represent the energy that want to give to the upper part of body, from the throat to the jaw muscles, to the lips, to the cheeks, to the ear, to the nose, to the eyes, forehead, all the way up to above crown of the head. So we're gonna say MA with our mouth closed. So say MA when you're exhaling for 3 rounds. All right, so keep your lips closed when you say the word MA. Inhale. And just keep your eyes closed softly and gently. Whether you keep your hands on your thighs or you keep your hands on your chest, all right? We come to the last part of our session today. One thing that I want to tell you guys, wherever we are right now in this part of the world, I want you to make sure that we are so grateful to be a human being. We are so grateful to be alive and able to wake up each and every morning to do something really good to ourselves and to the world. We are full of love, of loving kindness and care. Thanks to Sugar to introduce me to your guy and allow me to share the knowledge of the yoga to you. And I hope you're able to receive some of the positive energy that I give to you. And once again, I'm so grateful to be part of this team, and hopefully that we're gonna see each other next time. So stay safe, stay home, stay positive, and always smile to the stranger, because nobody knows, they might want to receive the energy from you as well. So thank you so much and see you next time. Namaste. Khopunka. Salamat po. What else that I should learn? Walang anuman. Maybe. So see you guys then. Bye bye.